Most businesses that invest in Facebook advertising often are so confused because they have no idea which ads are working, which ads are not, or anything that will actually help them track return on investment. There are two pretty simple things that can help you understand your data so much more clearly. The very first thing that we're gonna go through is how to customize your columns in Facebook Ads Manager so that you can see the data that matters the most to you. The next thing you're gonna have to look at is, do you actually have the appropriate events installed on your key pages so that you can track this data? If those events don't exist, you won't be able to track anything from the past. You will be able to track everything moving forward. And that is going to be of critical importance to giving you confidence to invest in this type of advertising, knowing that you are spending the money on the ads that are working best. So let's go ahead and dive in. Log in to Ads Manager. By default, the columns are set to performance. Most people never even know that there are a lot of other options that they can select. Setup, delivery, video engagement, offline conversions. I don't feel like there's any great default. So what you want to do is create your own custom set of data in this platform to see what matters most. You're going to go to the very bottom and click Customize Columns. What you're going to see is everything that is currently in that drop down. So right now, performance is what was selected. So I'm seeing everything that's in that performance tab. You also have the ability to reorganize these so that you can actually tie the data together. I want to know how many clicks I've gotten, what my cost per click is, my click-through rate, all right next to each other, as opposed to hopping back and forth. It's going to help you understand the data much better. I'm going to show you what I prefer. If there are pieces of data that matter to you, just add them in. It's not a problem, and there is no ultimate wrong answer. Delivery refers to, is this ad delivering or not? So I'm going to leave that there. The ad set name is the next thing I see. That matters not when I'm looking at my ads dashboard. I want to know about my results. Bid strategy is the next one that you'll see. To me, I always use a very similar bid strategy, so I'm gonna X that out as well. Budget is a good one to have. Last significant edit, I'm gonna erase that as well. Results is the next one that I'm gonna keep. Reach and impressions are not the most important to me, so I will leave them in this data, but I'm gonna push them towards the back so that I can see the cost and results focused data up front. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take cost per result and I'm going to drag it next to result. I wanna see my results and my cost per result right next to each other. We also have quality ranking, engagement rate ranking, and conversion rate ranking. I have not necessarily found a direct correlation towards what they say in terms of the quality of my ad and the actual financial results that they're producing. I'm gonna move amount spent up next to budget. I wanna see my budget. I wanna see the amount that I've already spent. Schedule is relating to the schedule that your ads are running. If you don't set up schedules for your ads, such as the days of the week that they're running or the times of the day, you don't need that either. As you can see, we're removing a lot of the default options that they've given you. It's no wonder people are so confused in their Ads Manager dashboard. Frequency is something that does matter to me, and I'm gonna move that up. Unique link clicks is another great one. We're also gonna move that up. Landing page views will go next to link clicks. And then overall link clicks, you can leave that if you want. I'm also gonna drag up cost per landing page view right next to my landing page views. Those were all the default options. Now we're gonna add the options that we really wanna see. If you track CPM, that is another one you're definitely going to want to track. So I'm gonna put that in between reach and frequency. Then we have the page post section. What I like to see is post comments, and those are going to be below the link clicks. Post shares, because that's another thing that matters to me. That's helping me be exposed to a larger audience for free. Now we're starting to get into our costs and some of the more important data. Cost per post engagement. This is where you're going to track your CPE or your cost per post engagement. We also could see new messaging connections, cost per new messaging connection, and cost per messaging connection started or conversation started. if you are using Messenger objectives, those are absolutely things that you would want to see on your dashboard. Now we scroll down and we get into the media section, which is relating to video. Cost per through play is my primary metric for measuring video. I'm going to drag that above post comments. The next thing that I want to do is track how many people are watching my videos at different percentages. So I'm going to click 25%, 50%, 75%, and 95%. Do you need all of those? Maybe, maybe not. But what I do like to see is what the drop-off is at every one of those stages. That's gonna give you really good insight into how long people are watching, but what sections of your video have the biggest drop-off? Take a look at those sections and improve them for the future so that you get more people to complete the actual video. Average video playtime, that's another one I'm gonna drag next to my other video metric. Now we're gonna scroll down to clicks. Link click-through rate is actually the one that I wanted, and that's because my click-through rate is gonna be for all of the clicks, including someone clicking the read more button. I really care about that link click-through rate. So make sure you are selecting the right one. The cost per link click is another one that we're definitely going to add. And then we get into the most important section possible, our standard events. Standard events are gonna help you understand what people are doing. If you have standard events installed on key pages on your website, this is how you're gonna track them and the cost. There's a lot of events ultimately that you can add, but complete registration, submit application, schedule, those are the three that I use primarily. Those are all done in the events manager section, a business manager. They have a very easy setup tool that allows you to plug in your URL, decide what you wanna track, and super simply install those events. This is crucial to understanding your return on investment. Go ahead and select the events that we have. Registrations completed, my total and my cost, appointments scheduled, applications submitted. I'm selecting total and cost for all of them. I personally drag cost per schedule and schedule at the very top of my page. This is the primary focus for me of understanding if I'm achieving my core goals. Now I'm gonna click this check mark, save as preset. Name it whatever you want that helps you identify that this is important. You're now going to click apply. You're going to see exactly what you want to see, and you're going to see it in the order in which you want to see it. So now under columns, I see that I'm on my test dashboard. If you need to update that in the future, you're going to go back to customize columns, make your changes, but again, click save as preset. It will overwrite that. You're going to be more aware and more effective with your advertising. If you want to learn more about how to optimize your Facebook ads, get more scheduled calls, get more booked appointments, then click on this playlist and dive in. Or if you want to learn specifically how to set up custom conversions and standard events, there's also going to be a link for you. So check it out right now and get those installed.